Welcome to Project Pro Code Recipes. In this video, we are going to learn on how to handle outliers in a data frame. So this is the code snippet over here. I have copied this code and I have pasted that in my Jupyter notebook. I'll explain to you the code over here as well as run this for you. So first, let me clear my kernel. Now, what is outliers? So outliers is the term that we have generally used a lot at the time of data analysis, but have never understood what it actually means. So outliers are the out of the range values. Basically, in a simple terms, you can understand out of the range values. For example, you have been given, for example, consider you're working for a store. Now your daily sales of a store is 200 rupees to 300 rupees, but suddenly there's a season of marriages. So your store sells a lot. So basically, in just two to three days, your sales soars up to be around 10,000 per day. Now, if I ask you, what is your average sale per year? You should not use those 10,000 or 20,000 values and add that up in your numbers to give me an buffed up average for your shop. And that is as that is not your the usual trend of sales that your shop is doing. So basically, those are actually known as outliers. When we don't remove those outliers from our model suits up our model sometime predicts wrong values for different data points. Basically, your model gets trained on some of those very unusual numbers. It picks up very random patterns due to those unusual high numbers, and the robustness of your model decreases. So robustness is actually how better a model can perform on unseen data points is known as robustness. So basically, the better your model can perform, the more robust your model is. So that I was saying, if you don't remove those outliers, your model is going to be less robust as compared to the models in which you have already removed the outliers. Okay. So now let's get started with the codes. So print format, how to deal with the outliers in Python. Now warnings, warning dot filter ignore. So import numpy as np and pandas as pd. Now here I'm creating a data frame. First I initiated an empty data frame named using pandas. So pd dot data frame, you just need to use these two small brackets to initialize an empty data frame. Now I'm adding columns one by one. So houses, price, these are the prices of my houses, bathrooms. So the number of bathrooms are 2, 3.5, 2, and 116. So square feet is 1525 and 1548 thousand. Okay, so you can see for a house, for basically let's consider example of house bathrooms. You can see the number of bathroom 116 is completely an outlier, that one cannot expect a house to have 116 bathrooms. So this outlier can also be a consequence of wrong entries. Maybe someone was trying to enter 6 and by mistake he did 116. Okay, now so this was I consider this as an outlier in my house data frame, so I need to drop that. So basically, one way to deal with that is houses, bathrooms and less than 20. That is, I'll drop all those observations where my number of bathrooms is less than 20. So print h, that is, this means go to house and drop all the houses less than 20. Now after that, I'm creating a new feature outlier. So what I am doing, np dot where houses bathroom. So go to house of bathroom less than, these are two boolean values that I want to fill in. So 0 and 1. That where my bathroom is less than 20, fill it to be 0, and where my bathroom is greater than 20, fill it to be 1. Now, one more method of doing this is you can rescale your features. So houses log of square feet np dot log x for x in house. That is, here I am doing the rescaling of my feature for square feet. Okay, so I am taking log of these values to rescale the feature. So np dot log x for x in houses square feet. Now basically, rescaling is used when you don't want to actually drop your outliers, as these outliers seems important to you. Okay, for example, consider a township. Now those townships generally have only two type of buildings, that are flats and then a simple skyline flats, and then bungalows. You haven't gone for duplexes. So basically, now your simple flats have a build up area of consider 2000 square feet, whereas if you would have given a duplex, then the build up area would have been of around of those duplexes would have been around of 3000. But as you directly went to the bungalow, the build up area shoots to be 20,000. Now in those cases, you also cannot drop these data points for bungalows, as they are essential part of your real estate. So in those cases, you need to rescale them. So here is what I am doing. Now you can see in these I dropped the place where houses is less than greater than 20. In other, I marked them using the Boolean expression. And in this, I did a rescaling that I rescaled. Now the 10 doesn't look like an outlier in my data set anymore. So this was some method. One of the most important method and the basic mathematical model of how to calculate an outlier is by using interquartile range. So let me show you this with help of an example. So this was a data set that I was working on. This was basically a Big Mart sales project that had data of a Big Mart company. During pre-processing, one of the best method of exactly identifying outliers is that whether your data actually contains outliers or not is using a box plot. So you can see here I did a box plot. So basically all these dots values above this line are outliers. This means my data has outliers. Now how to calculate the exact outliers? So what I will do, I will calculate the quantile range of 0.25% of the data, then 0.75% of the data. So you can see what I took my data frame df, then I directly wrote data.df.quantile 0.25. It calculates the quantile range for all of the numerical values in my data set. 3 df.quantile 0.75, it will calculate the quantile range q3 for all the all my data sets, all my numerical values in the data sets. Then I need to calculate the interquartile range IQR. So Q3 minus Q1 will be my interquartile range. So you can see I printed out my quantile, my interquantile, my interquantile range, the quantile, the Q3 and the Q1. So these are all my IQR, Q3 and Q1 respectively. Now I want to calculate the number of outliers. There are two types of outliers. One, those are having very less values, and one, those are having very high values. For example, as I was giving you example of a sales store, so 10,000 is an outlier as well, whereas 10 rupees is also an outlier, as that is not what is a general trend that your that sales of your shop is following. So Q3 plus 1.5 times IQR, this will give me the upper bound of the interquartile of the outliers, and Q1 minus IQR will give me the lower bound. Okay, so you can see. Okay, now so this is my outlier value. So basically all the MRPs above 323 are my outliers. All the item outlet sales above 6501 is my outliers. All the item visibility above 0.195608 is outliers. Okay, so here I've defined a function to calculate the number of outliers. So def total outliers qxy, this will take two inputs, c equal to 0 for I in x. If I is greater than y, c equal to c plus 1, print c. That is, it actually acts as a counter for me. It calculates the number of outliers. So I'm calling my total outlier function. Now df.itemOutlet, that is the column for which I want to calculate the outlet, and here I am passing the value. So you can see 186 values are outliers in item outlet sales, and 259 values are outliers in item visibility. Okay, so this was all about codes in this video. For more industry relevant projects, you can visit our website, and for more code recipes like this, you can visit our website as well as our YouTube channel. You can also use this click here function to submit your request for customized code. The URL for the code in these videos is available in the description below. Thank you.